Now that we know what the reorder buffer is supposed to look like, let's see how it's used. For that, we need the reorder buffer with its commit and issue points, and we need the rest of the processor that we have already seen. The instruction queue, reservation stations, registers, and the RAT. Let's say that we have this add instruction here in the instruction queue, so now we want to see what happens once we start issuing this all the way to once we eventually commit this instruction in a processor that now has a reorder buffer. So let's first see what happens on instruction issue. As before, when we didn't have the reorder buffer, we get a free reservation station and we put our instruction in it. Now that we do have a reorder buffer, we will also get one of those, unlike reservation station where we just need a free one, it doesn't matter which one it is. Here, we need to get the entry that is the next one at the issue point. So our instruction will go here in the reorder buffer. That, of course, also means that our issue point will now move and points to the next entry in the reorder buffer. So now we have 7 instructions that have been issued and have not yet committed. Another thing that we had to do when we were issuing instructions in Tomasulo's algorithm is that the RAT entry for R1, the destination register of the instruction, needed to be pointed to the reservation station for the instruction. We will still need to do this pointing, but instead of the reservation station, now we point the RAT entry to the ROB entry for the instruction. That means that this RAT entry will be now, instead of pointing to the reservation station, be pointing to this entry here. So overall, at the end of the cycle, when we issue this instruction, we will occupy a reservation station with the values that we found for these registers. We will make the RAT point to the ROB6 entry. And in this entry, we will say that R1 will need to be written for this instruction, and we don't still have the value. So the done bit is 0 here for this instruction. Now this add here might wait for operands to become ready. And that happens exactly as before with Tomasulo's algorithm. We just capture results that we need, and we are ready to dispatch once we have all the operands. Eventually, the add has all the things that it needs to dispatch, and the dispatching works exactly the same as before. So we check whether the operands are ready, and when they are, we send the instruction for execution. But now we can also free the reservation station as soon as we dispatch. Previously, with Tomasulo's algorithm, we needed to wait for the reservation station release all the way until this instruction broadcasts its result. That was needed because the reservation station serves as the name for the result. Now that the name for the result is the ROB entry, we no longer need the reservation stations to play that role. So the reservation station now does only its primary job, which is wait for operands and capture them, and then figure out which instructions to dispatch. After that, the reservation station for the instruction is done, so we can free it. So now our add executes and carries with it the tag of ROB6, which is the name for its result. Eventually, it produces a result.